I'm Nick Pettit.
I'm Jason Seifer.
And you're watching the Treehouse Show, your weekly dose of internets, where we talk about all things web design, web development, and more.
In this episode, we're going to be going over subtle patterns that you can use in your web pages, design patterns in JavaScript, and the usual interesting roundup of JavaScript projects, as well as coding tools.
Let's get into it. First up is Subtle Patterns at subtlepatterns.com. This is a collection of, you guessed it, subtle patterns that you can use as background images for your web pages. Now, these are all free. You can go ahead and just look at them in a list or as thumbnails. And this may be a little bit too subtle to come across on the YouTubes, but I promise you that all of these gray areas are actually really nice patterns. Now, this is always nice to include in your web pages because it adds just a little bit of texture to the backgrounds and, you know, makes it seem like a richer visual experience.
Kind of ties the site together.
Yeah, really ties the room together.
Like that lamp from IKEA.
Yeah, or maybe a rug, perhaps.
So next up, we're going to be talking about understanding design patterns in JavaScript. This is a blog post over on the NetToots blog talking about why you want to understand design patterns in the JavaScript programming language. The reason you would want to understand design patterns in JavaScript is that so you can actually implement them on your own JavaScript sites or work with existing JavaScript libraries and actually understand what's going on. This is an excellent blog post for people who have, you know, kind of dabbled in some JavaScript and really want to understand how the language works. It goes over the different types of design patterns available in JavaScript, how to deal with privacy of classes and attributes, and what happens inside of design patterns while you're building your applications. This is all part of a book by Adi Osmani. And you can go ahead and read that book called Learning JavaScript Design Patterns. There's a link to it at the end of the article. Great blog post. I definitely recommend reading it if you want to brush up on your JavaScript.
Really, really cool stuff. Next up is Zoomooz.js. That's Zoom and then Zoom spelled backwards.js. This is a really cool project that allows you to zoom or skew or scale your web pages with just a little piece of JavaScript.
Whoa.
So you go ahead and click on this stuff.
Whoa!
And you can actually zoom the entire web page. Now, I don't know how to zoom out, so I'm just going to go ahead and refresh the page here. You can actually find this project on GitHub, and it's a jQuery plugin. So if you just put jQuery onto your site, you can go ahead and drop it right in there.
Kids these days with their JavaScript and their zooming and rotating.
And their jQuery using plugins and stuff.
Get off of our web lawns.
Yeah.
Next up, we have an app called Prototypes. What this is going to do is let you turn your static designs into tappable iPhone prototypes. Now, it's worth noting that this is a paid application. They are not sponsoring the Treehouse Show.
Shame on them.
Shame on them. But what this is great. You upload a static version of your website, and then you can actually turn this into a tappable application, more for demos. You know, you want to show somebody how your site's going to work, maybe get some feedback on the application. And boom, use prototypes, just drag and drop into the application, kind of work with the behavior a little bit, and you are good to go. And that's at prototypesap.com.
Pretty cool stuff. A common question that we get a lot at Treehouse is, when can I use this HTML5 element or this CSS thing or, you know, whatever it may be? And usually the place we direct them to is, can I use .com. This is a really nifty reference where you can go ahead and just look at CSS properties or HTML5 elements. And when you click into an individual property or element, you'll be presented with this really nice table that shows you the support in various browsers and their various versions. It'll also give you kind of a status update in terms of what percentage of browsers support that, which is really nice. So if you're thinking about, you know, do I want to go ahead and jump into the future with this CSS3 rounded corner thing? Is it really going to be seen by a large percentage of people? Of course, that actually depends more so on your users and who's actually visiting your website, but it's still nice to get a good idea before you embark on a new web project, whether or not something's actually going to be used before you have traffic.
And stay tuned after the show. Nick and I are actually going to read off every single CSS and HTML property, as well as the browsers that it supports, right after the show. This is going to be our special 6.5 hour long episode of the Treehouse Show.
Pretty exciting.
Next up is Cookie.js. This simplifies cookies in JavaScript. So what that does is it gives you an abstraction when working with cookies in JavaScript. It does not require jQuery. And you have one single interface, cookie.set. Set the key, the value, it could be anything, you know, hash, object, anything that JavaScript supports can be put inside of this cookie. A few different options and just a really, really nice library for working with cookies in the browser.
Pretty nifty. Next up is gauge.coffee, and this is a project that's available on GitHub. It allows you to create these really neat gauges that are animated. So if you want to show, I don't know, maybe how many people have visited your site lately, you can go ahead and put a gauge on your website that will represent that. The nice thing about this is that you can go ahead and customize it with all these little sliders here where you can change, you know, maybe the animation speed, the angle at which the gauge is at, or the font size, all sorts of stuff. And then you can go ahead and just drop the code right into your website. And it's actually available as a jQuery plugin, but jQuery is not required.
I think it adds about 50 horsepower to your website.
Yeah, at least. It's going to make your website run a lot faster.
Just having that gauge on there, because it says the numbers.
No, that's...
So you know it's true.
That's terrible advice. Don't listen to us.
So next up over on the SitePoint blog is a discussion of using an HTML5 shim or Internet Explorer emulation mode. So what this means is if you want to add certain HTML5 features that maybe aren't available in something like Internet Explorer 7 or 8, well, you can use JavaScript for an HTML5 shim. This is just a piece of JavaScript that you install on the site, and it allows those browsers to work with your HTML5 elements. So you can also accomplish certain things by putting Internet Explorer into emulation mode for IE7, IE8, and there's actually a bizarre IE5 emulation mode. I don't know why you'd ever want to emulate that, but you have the option. So the problem is, if you use one of these emulation modes and then somebody has your site in an iframe on their site, but they're in something like Internet Explorer 7 emulation, well, the HTML5 shim, or if you put your site into Internet Explorer 9 mode, is not going to work. It's going to be IE7 mode all the way down.
So in other words, if you have your stuff in an iframe in somebody else's website, they are using Internet Explorer 7 emulation mode, that's actually going to cascade down to your iframe.
Exactly.
Got it.
So the solution is a bit of a strange one. You have to use the HTML5 shim in all of the different versions all the way up to Internet Explorer 9. So there's an interesting article about this with a little bit more depth and discussion over on the SitePoint blog. And you can find that link in the show notes for the Treehouse Show.
Very cool stuff. Well, that is it for this week's episode of the Treehouse Show. Thank you so much for watching. And if you have any cool tips, tricks, or tools, be sure to tweet us. I am at NickRP.
I am at Jay Seifer. Thanks everybody for tuning in, and we will see you next time.
See you later.